Hello everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about the gold and the silver market analysis and its strategies, price action and the trade setups for the upcoming weeks. First we look into the silver market. Last week I have mentioned that currently in the downtrend, the idea was to sell here and see and trade based on the confirmations. The price is consolidating and ranging in this particular area. The price actually held in this zone for an entire week. It did manipulate here and formed a pattern and it trapped many traders. Let me zoom on to the lower time frame. This is the high and this is the low of the previous week. These two are the high and low of the week before that. So as we can see, the price actually didn't even break the high and low of this particular high and low. So it tried to range in this particular zone. So I have zoomed in to the H1 time frame. Here actually the price tries to break here, but it couldn't and fell down. The second time it tried here, the third time it tried to break up, but it couldn't. Again we saw a huge drop here. So the price is clearly ranging. In the bottom of this range, we see here price two times touches the same price and it tries to break down, but it couldn't. It got rejected and it went up. Here you can see that the price has been broken a bit by a few pips, but again it got rejected by here by this candle and we saw a huge spike towards the upside. Many bought here and they got trapped, and the stop loss were here and it got hit. So first you should understand the volatility and the speed of the market and where the market is actually ranging. So we have seen that the high and low price, it hasn't been taken out yet. So the price, it tries to go up and down and it is ranging and it is manipulating and it is taking the buyers and sellers out of the market. Let's move on to the daily. So in daily, the price has to take out this high and this high as well. It has to close above this level so the price can push further up. We need more confirmations and based on that we enter here. In H4 time frame, usually when the market ranges for a whole week or for up to 10 days or 8 days or 9 days or so, usually the market, it tends to break up hard. It means the price, it can actually go up more or go down and break down in a huge way. So this week it is going to be very crucial and it has already trapped many traders here, so you should watch out and enter late during the US session. It can start moving very fast. This strategy and the idea which I am telling you right now, this goes to the both gold and silver. During the Monday, you can see a nice movement up or down. During Asian session, usually the gold and silver, it moves really good. If not, you can see a good movement during the US session. So time is very, very important here. Okay, let me show you my encoded calculation for silver. These are the encoded lines I have calculated for the silver. Here you can see the price here, 26.648, 26.519, 26.004, 25.601, 25.480. These are very, very important levels. Usually I use these levels to forecast the price. Each and every line has its own calculation. So the future market, most of the time, it works perfectly in these areas, and most of the line, the price, it holds there and decides there actually. I have seen the institutions, banks and big boys take entries in these kind of areas. So I have calculated it. So make sure you place these lines in your chart and trade based on these lines. As you can see, I have forecasted this 2 to 3 weeks earlier itself. The price exactly held there and dropped, and this price it's holding here. The next time when it drops, it can actually come here and it will decide here for sure. When it holds here, when we see some other patterns or some other strategies, candlestick patterns, other confirmations or confluence here, we look to buy here and most likely the price will hold here. If not, it can come, it can actually drop to here. Once this level it gets broken, it can drop here. There is a very good chance, if and only if it drops, it can retest here and drop to here. Here I will be looking to buy. So either we are seeing a nice good drop up to here, nice drop from here to here, or we are going to see a drop and a retest here, and from there it can drop here. So based on these levels, we adapt and we trade. It is almost same as the previous week I have mentioned in my previous video, and that's it for silver. Now we shall move on to the gold. The market is holding here, it's trying to break up or down, and it is deciding here actually. Let's see in the H4 time frame. This is the previous week high and low. This is the high and low of the week before that. Here we see a clear indication of price rejection here. Once it touches the weekly low, the price it tends to bounce up. So the price moved up and it got rejected here. It actually took the orders here, it took the stop losses here and it went up. So here we are seeing a pattern within patterns. The trend line method, it has worked really good here. The price, it broke the trend line, it touches the low here, it got rejected, it went on to the top, it broke the high here, it retested the trend line and it dropped again. So the price is holding a bit here. So not only that, you can see it formed a head and shoulder pattern. So up, down, up, down, up and down. So it is a head and shoulder pattern. We see a trend line here. It all worked out perfectly. Let me zoom on to the H1 time frame. Price action stopped here at this point many times. 1, 2, 3, 4 and etc. So the price actually what it did was it moved up and it dropped. As it dropped in the silver, again it dropped massively. So last week we saw a huge rejection here and we saw a huge range of price action. There is a zone formation here, you can see here. So the price actually hunted this low and it pushed up. Again it hunted these two highs and again it dropped a bit. Again we see a nice manipulation here. So it is pattern within patterns. We saw a nice drop here and a price hunt here, and from there it gets rejected, and from here it start pushing up to the next zone and it is searching for the liquidity, and it should be at this point. So there are many stops here, many orders here. Since there is a zone here, many traders would have placed their stops and orders here. So it hunted there and it started to drop nicely. So look at the pips here. It's almost this candle alone, 230 almost. So the previous drop was 260, but I have combined these two candles. But when we see as a single candle, you can see 140, but it followed through. But we saw only a single drop here, but here we saw a nice drop. So the price, what it indicates is the price, it tries to go up, but it's not, it's rejecting. One more rejection we saw, there is a order filling here, so the price is most likely to drop a bit down. Now let me show my encoder calculation. This is my encoder calculation, which I have calculated for this particular gold market. These levels are calculated weeks ahead itself. You can see the price here, 1792.93, 1787.75, 1771.37, 1766.29, 1750.24. These are all very important price. As mentioned during my silver analysis, it plays utmost importance. You can see the price, initial price, which has stopped here, and it formed both the shoulders here. This is the head and shoulder pattern. So we saw a head and two shoulders here. So all those decision areas were made in this perfectly calculated area. This works perfectly in the future market. You will see in the upcoming weeks and days the price, it should hold here, and it will take decisions based on these calculated levels only. For the upcoming week and the week, the price is expected to drop down a bit. So it can drop, it can retest and drop here, or it can drop nicely. So once, if the level 1750.24 didn't hold, it can actually drop here, same as silver. It can drop here, from here it can bounce up. So once this bounce is over, we will decide based on that. So based on the price formation here, we will decide. And in case the price didn't drop and it is and the price went up, the price has to go up and close in the daily and weekly. It is of very much important. Even if it closes in the daily, we trade and we enter based on the confluence and the correlations and some other price action confirmations that we get in this particular encoded region. The price usually tends to retest here and go up. So we should ready to adapt based on the candle patterns and other confirmations we get here. So as of now, we are looking to sell here. In case if we see a reversal here, this will be our reversal trade. So that's it for gold. So do not gamble, take any one instrument and master that. Either trade silver or trade gold, whichever suits your trading edge, choose that and manage your risk properly and trade according to your risk management plan and your trading plan. If you have any doubts, you can contact me in the Telegram. This is my Telegram channel. This is my contact ID. Here I post my trading analysis and forecast regularly. So join this, and if there is any changes, I update here. So make sure you join this. Also, you subscribe to my YouTube channel. See you in the next video.